first arrived at the airport, we were already extremely excited. We couldn't wait to start our adventure, so saying goodbye to our parents was the easiest thing.
I don't know, I'm really happy. It's just something I've wanted for a long time.
At first, I really didn't know what I was getting into. We didn't know much about what we were going to go through on this trip.
And we're here! Yay!
Do you know where
we're
supposed to go?
I have no idea.
The first day, we went for a walk next to the refugee to contemplate the mountains.
That simple moment, sitting down quietly before the mountains, taught me to value the small things and to be thankful for the things that in our usual lives we wouldn't even notice.
In which we would engage in activities with the blind people. However, we were warned that nothing would go as planned. It scared me, but they were right. It wasn't as we planned. It was better. It was much better.
At first, I didn't know how to interact with them, and the fact that they only spoke Spanish made it even harder. When they arrived, I was almost in shock, and I didn't know what to do or how to act around them, but it seemed like they were prepared for that. And the kids themselves helped me to help them.
We danced, played, and taught the children how to play the pandeiro. We even brought brigadeiro for them to try it, and sang Brazilian songs with them.
So, we woke up this morning, it was really cold, and we had a little warm-up where we stretched outside and got everyone warmed and massaged their friends and got to know each other better. It's a girl's birthday, Sofia, which sleeps in our room, so we're thinking about doing something for her.
This trip was guided by one of the wisest persons we've ever met. It was absolutely life-changing experience. Everyone and everything was so welcoming. While some people spend years in your life and make absolute no difference, others are so special that only need 6 days to make themselves very missed.
In this trip, I've overcome many of my fears and challenged myself, but still knowing my limits. And as Jack said, we need to learn how to go beyond our comfort zone, entering our learning zone, but never going over it into the danger zone. Just wanna go home.
It was unique.
One single letter.
I've been keeping all the letters that I wrote to you. Each one in line too. I'm fine, baby, how are you? Well, I would send them, but I know that it's just not enough. My words were cold and flat, and you deserve more. Another aeroplane, another sunny place. I'm lucky, I know, but I wanna go home. I got to go home. Let me go home. I'm just too far from where you are. I wanna come home. And I feel just like I'm living someone else's life. It's like I just stepped outside.